us direction from above. We need a word.
Nelson, I can't help you there. But one of the ways that you can tell that somebody has a mental disorder is that they don't feel it.
My Lord.
Or they don't have the competent abilities to solve problems.
And give us peace.
One of the ways that they say that they test your abilities mentally is that they would, back in the old days, I think this is more folklore than anything, that they would put you in a room with a mop, and they would turn the faucet on, and they would let the faucet overflow. And if you just stayed there just mopping up the water,
all right,
and you didn't have enough sense to turn off the faucet.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, you're not qualified. Yeah.
Yeah. You didn't have enough sense to turn off the faucet and you just kept mopping up.
My Lord. My Lord. All right.
Oh, the psalmist in the text saw the water dripping, and he started to complain within himself, and he started to mop some stuff up, and he talked about being disturbed, and he talked about being downcast, and he was mopping up the water with the mop, but then he had enough sense to turn off the faucet by answering his own question.
All right, well.
If you're going to start a conversation with yourself, you have to end up with the right answer. Yeah. And in the text, as we go to point number 3, what was his desire? The desire, he turned on the faucet and said, hey, wait a minute, I'm not going to allow my circumstances, my tribulations, cause me to lose my mind. I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to lose it like that.
Yeah.
I'm going to answer my own question. And my own question, I have
put
to
your
say,
hope.
Put your hope.
Yes, sir.
In God.
Hey. Well, I will. Yes, sir. Yes, praise.
Oh, the devil is trying to make you lose your mind. I like that song singer said, y'all about to make me lose my mind. Yeah. Up in here. All right. But the psalmist said that there's no tribulation, there's no problems that's going to cause me to lose my mind. I may get downcast. I may be disturbed at times. But what I have to do in those times is I have to put my hope in God.
Yeah.
Give God a hand clap.
Yes, sir.
Up in here.
Yes, sir.
The devil almost had you.
Mm-hmm.
Well.
You thought you were about to lose it.
Mm-hmm. All right.
You lose it.
All right.
So now, as a matter of fact, you're about to gain some stuff.
All right. Go ahead. Yeah.
For the psalmist said in 37, that's why it's good when you talk to yourself. It's good, and this is spiritual warfare, that you know the scripture and the word of God. And when you get down and start talking crazy to yourself, you got to learn what God says. And the psalmist says in Psalms 37:25, wait a minute, I was young.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right.
And now I'm old.
Yeah.
That'll preach in itself. I gotta go on.
Never seen
the righteous forsaken. Yeah. Oh, I've never seen the righteous.
Yeah.
Or even that children.
That's the word. Amen.
Because if you Yeah. God's going to take care of you yes, and sir. Your children. Oh, yeah. Got another hand clap.
Yes, sir.
Praise. Up in here.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Thank you.
Yes, yeah. Thank you.
Put your hope in God.
Yeah.
Say to your neighbor, neighbor.
Yeah.
Neighbor.
Yeah.
Put your hope in God.
In God.
In Jesus'
in
name.
Jesus.
Give God another hand yes, clap of praise. Up in here, up in here.
Yes, Lord. Yeah.
One of the ways that you know that yes, you put Lord. Your hope in God.
Yes.
Is in your ability to praise him.
All right. Go ahead. Go ahead. Yeah, I know you're right.
That's it.
That's what Job had to do when he had lost everything. And he wrote a psalm almost over 4,000 years ago that we still sing today. Praising God. Praising God. In the middle of the circumstances. Go back. Oh, what's that? Yeah, praising God in the middle of the circumstances. He says, for I will yet praise him. Oh, does anybody in here know about that yet?
Yes, sir.
Well, if you don't, you better find out. Praise him. Because your family can be falling apart, but you're going to yet praise him. You may not know how you pay your bills, but you're going to yet praise him. Oh, you may not have a job this month. You may think you're about to get cut, but you're yet praise. You better learn to get some of that yet praise in you, in Jesus.
That'll work.
You're going to get some yet praise in you, in Jesus' name. That's the only thing that's going to enable you to keep your mind in this time, in this turbulent time when they say that our world is about to fall apart. You better yet praise him. Whether things are going well on Wall Street or Main Street, you better yet praise him. Whether the banks are going bust, you better yet praise him. Whether the automobile companies are going bust,
yes, sir. Yes, praise.
Your family is falling apart. Somebody in here again say,
praise
him. Give him some
Yes, sir.
You got it made right now. Amen.
Yes,
you know, I look and I see sad faces. Amen. You may have come with a sad face. A disturbed face. A messed up face. Amen. God, God gave you good news. God want to tell you. Amen. If you got a mental problem. Amen.
Another calm on the sea. But what we need is a special word that will burn within our heart and give us direction from above.